Dear brothers, we are going to read from the 17th Sunday in ordinary time. 17th Sunday in ordinary time, and my audience is the parish setup, the mixed audience.
Jesus is teaching us to be using.
And in this homily, I will use two important words from the Hebrew language, which depict the meaning of the same Our Father. We shall hear that as we proceed. Let me begin by asking this important question. Do we have an idea why did the disciples decide to ask Jesus to teach them how to pray? Or what comes to our mind when we hear the word prayer? First of all, John the Baptist had the disciples also, and he taught them how to pray. So the disciples of Jesus had that an idea that much as John the Baptist taught the disciples, his followers, how to pray, but what about Jesus, our master? Is he not going to show us how to pray? And then Jesus did the same, and he gives the Lord's Prayer, the Our Father. But then, in this prayer, we come to understand the definition of prayer itself. And if we have an idea about what prayer is, the Our Father itself is the best and greatest example of the meaning of prayer. Prayer simply means communication with God. We speak to God, and that is prayer. We express our needs, we express our thanksgiving, we express all our feelings. We are talking to God, and that is prayer. But then what stands out in this prayer is that we are calling God our Father. We are calling him our Father, but not the earthly Father, the heavenly Father. In this, Jesus gives two important parables. The first one, he's giving an example, as we heard in the gospel, where a man visits his friends and he continues to persist, to make noise so that his friend may wake up and provide the needs of his friend. But to shut his friend up, and in order not to continue the disturbance, the friend will still wake up and provide that. And if we are able to do that to our friends as earthly people, what more can God do to his people? And then the second example is how God knows what we really need. If our earthly fathers are asked bread, they are able to provide bread and not something else, not the scorpion, we know if it is God, he will give us what is best and not what the human father can give. And this is the point at which I want now to talk about the two important words which are used in Hebrew. And this is Abba. Abba, we get it also in the Old Testament. Abba means father. And this is the title which we attribute to God. And then we have another word called Av. Av. Av is a Hebrew word which means dad. But in Hebrew, these two words are used differently. When you say Abba, it means I am addressing the father who cares, the father who has the responsibility over the children. But if I use the word Av, Av refers to anyone who has children, regardless of the support. So the Av is like the heavenly father, the earthly father, who can either take care of his children or not. So in this gospel of today, we hear that we have the Abba Father, the Father who cares. And in this gospel, since the Father cares, we must go away with the message that our God is a God who cares, who provides for us. And this should be the general prayer which should accompany us in our journey as Christians. And most importantly, we must also understand that it encompasses all our needs as human beings and the moral life we need to live in our society. And it also further ends by encouraging us to forgive one another in our societies, because we also acclaim that may the Father forgive us our sins as we forgive those who trespass against us. So as we pray and know that the Father cares for us, but also he forgives us, and he sets an example that we should also be loving and we should also be forgiving, so that we may live very well in society. And as we are in this Eucharistic celebration, I pray that the Virgin Mary may continue to intercede for us and all the saints, and especially for us young people here, that the patron saint for the youth, St. John Bosco, may continue to intercede for us, so that we may be good people who have faith that our Father is caring for us, and also who know that as we present these our petitions, God hears them, and also we should be forgiving each other. And this is the call, not only to us young people, but to all of us in this gathering, in our different professions. Let us take these elements with